Happy Christmas month, everybody. I have a lot of work to do. I'm falling behind in my classes. In my room's a mess. How are y'all doing? The season's fucking over for my Bears. And we're gonna get a high draft pick, but just this once. I just want them to win a fucking game. Just one game. If the season ends like this, I would be content. I would be 100% content. But what's probably gonna happen is they win that game, they win that game, etch, and then we go back in time, and yeah, that's what's gonna happen. 14-3, actually 12-5, and then. Then we and then win the Super Bowl. Nah, I'm just kidding. Oh wait, no, that's the wrong season. But anyway, without further ado, it's week 13. I forgot to do a week 12 recap, so let's just do that real quick. That was a good game, a total blowout, but Texans had a real good garbage time performance versus Skyler, the quarterback. That was a great game by the Jags. Trevor Lawrence's best game of his career by far. A snooze fest on Monday night. Some inadequate coaching. Good Thanksgiving game. Good Thanksgiving game. Not so good Thanksgiving game. That game was kind of boring. I didn't even watch that game. That was a good Sunday night football game. Jordan Love looked pretty decent. Versus garbage time defense, I guess. Huh. This just shows how ineffective our offense is without Justin Fields, and Mike White is him. A terrible fucking game by the Broncos. They've reached rock bottom, but I wouldn't really say that because every time I do, they manage to surprise you even more and go further down. Terrible clock management by the Bucks. Again, they really, really had no business. They had no business losing. But they did. Las Vegas Raiders, great game. Good win by them. Helps our tank to the point where if we win this game and then lose out, we still should have what is our draft positioning? Okay, still in second. No, whatever. Okay, then decent win by the Chargers. Pretty much a blowout win by the Chiefs. Thought it would be a bit more. Anyway, that has been week 12 recapped. Now on to the week 13 predictions. Thursday night football game is today. I'm pretty sick right now. I got class today. I got work to do in a bit after this video's done. Both these teams are pretty decent. However, the Bills have been bullied by the Patriots far too long, and I don't think they're gonna let this fall behind. Went. I mean, well, might as well. There's no way we're winning that game. Okay, but yeah, I'm gonna hate the Bills in this one. 33 to 20. This is gonna be a game. Houston Texans versus the Browns. Deshaun Watson's great return. The Houston Texans are gonna try, and they're gonna make it a game, but I think it's gonna be a game that the Browns win. But it's gonna be a little too close for comfort. I don't think it's gonna be that good of a game. 27. Wait, no. 27-20. Broncos, Ravens, both teams are coming off losses, but they couldn't be any more different. Broncos just lost to one of the worst teams in the league that are still somehow in the playoff race because of an incredibly mediocre shit division in the NFC South. But regardless of that, looking at the Broncos' schedule, I think they get maybe three more wins. I'll say they get one big upset over the Chiefs somehow, because every team seems to get one of those wins every year, a massive upset. I say they beat the Rams, and then I say they beat the Chargers week 18 in a meaningless game. Maybe the Cardinals too, and that's about it. That's the best case 7-10. They're garbage, and they're not winning this game. Give me the fucking Broncos to win, not the Broncos, whatever, the Ravens to win 29-17. Chargers, Raiders, I don't know. I'm gonna have to go to the Chargers. The Raiders are coming off a really good win. Actually, no. I'm picking the Raiders. I'm gonna pick the Raiders. I'm picking the Raiders to win another close game. They got some momentum going, beating a good Seattle team. Give me the Raiders to win 26-23. Next up, Chiefs, Bengals, two good teams. Part three. The Bengals have won the last two matchups, including the AFC Championship. Both really good quarterbacks, really good offense. I think it's going to be a shootout. I'm going to take the Chiefs winning this one 38-36. Very close, very high scoring shootout game. The Jets versus the Vikes. Two good teams. Two above 500 playoff teams. The Jets are going to make this game. With Mike White. With Mike White. Mike White's a good backup. But he's not going to be your franchise guy. I think he'll fall back down to earth. But I do think he'll be performing a lot better than Zach Wilson. Give me the Vikings to win one at home by 10 points. 27-17. Next, like Jags, Lions. This is a really hard one to pick. Both teams are relatively in the same position. The Lions are 5-7 right now. Okay, both teams have the same record. But looking at the Lions' schedule, besides the Vikings, every single one of these is a winnable game. Where on paper they're the better team, including this one. Give me the Lions to win this one. Twenty-four to 21. Next up, Steelers, Falcons. Oh, Panthers are on a bye. Okay. I'm flummoxed by this one. Really good question. A real good conundrum. But Falcons are without Kyle Pitts. Steelers are coming off a win. I think just with how competitive this division is, I'm gonna go with the Falcons since it's at home and they're playing for a wild card game. They want the privilege of being the NFC South team to choke in the wild card round at home, and they're gonna get that. I think they're gonna try their best to get that ugly game. 23-21. 22. Next up, Eagles, Titans. Titans coming off a good game a couple weeks ago on Sunday Night Football. That was good, I guess. They lost to the Bengals for their first loss in oh, since that, before then they had that 5-game win streak after getting shlacked. Other than that, sloppy wins. Titans are a good team, but they're not going to beat the Eagles. Eagles move to 12-1, and I think with this win, they would let's actually check the playoff picture real quick. No teams are eliminated right now, but it's safe to say that the Broncos, Texans, Steelers, Browns, Raiders, and Jaguars are safely out of the playoff race by now. However, the Colts, Chargers, and Patriots are on the outside looking in. However, on the NFC, things are a lot more complicated. The Panthers have a 91% chance because of the division they're in. Same with the Saints. It's within 2 games, pretty much. The Rams are all but eliminated, and my Bears with a loss to the Packers, and the Seahawks beating the Rams, or the Giants tying the Commanders would eliminate us from the playoffs. I don't want that. I don't want the Packers to have the privilege of eliminating us from the playoff. At least wait another week. So it's safe to say that these two teams are eliminated. Cardinals are pretty much eliminated. Packers are pretty much eliminated. And with a loss to my Bears, they're eliminated from five, and then pretty much, yeah, if they lose this week, it's over for them. And then the Seahawks and Falcons are, and Lions are well alive in the playoff race, especially the Lions with an incredibly weak schedule. Looking at their schedule, if they probably will lose that Vikings game. If they can keep their shit together and go out 9-8 with a winning season, that is a very real shot, especially if the Commanders have a rough stretch. That is currently the Now let's check out the draft order. My Bears got a pretty much guaranteed top 5 pick, even if we win a game or two. Yeah, we're pretty much guaranteed to pick top 10. Anyway, without further ado, let's continue. Oh yeah, Eagles, I think they're gonna go out big, 30-17. No, not 27. 17. Dolphins, Niners. This is a really good one. Both teams are playing really elite right now, playing good football. Part of me wants the Lions to make the playoffs, though. I'm gonna go with the. This is really hard. But I guess I'm gonna have to go. Actually, no. I'm gonna actually take the 49ers. Okay, not a tie. I'm gonna take the 49ers to win a very close one at home. Off a game-winning touchdown drive or kick. 27-25. Next up, Colts, Cowboys. I don't think this will be a contest. The Cowboys are 8-3, and looking at their schedule, they have two more games they could lose. So at worst, I think they finish 12-5, maybe 11-6 of an upset, or if they clinch and want to bench their starters, I think Commanders might beat them. So no worse than 11-6. This is gonna be a win for them. Colts got something good with Jeff Saturday, but yeah. Give me the Cowboys to win this one, 27-13. Giants, Commanders. The Giants, they've dropped two straight. One of them, a game they should have not lost. They're 1-3 in their last 5 weeks, including the bye. Of course, you're 7-4. This isn't really a must-win. You're heavily favored for the playoffs right now. You have a where are the Giants at? Right now, the Giants. You win this game, you got a 28% chance. However, if you lose, it's starting to get a little dicey. So it's kind of a must-win game if you wanna not like if you wanna control your own destiny. But not a must-win game to make the playoffs. And I think they're going to take advantage of that. I think they get this one at home. 26, not 36. 26 to 19. No, not 29. To 19. Next up, Seahawks, Rams. The Rams are fucking garbage. I've never seen a case of Super Bowl hangover that bad. And looking at their schedule, my God. Looking at your schedule, who are they gonna beat? That's about it. They have three winnable games, and I'm assuming this is the Seahawks either have nothing to play for because they're eliminated, or they stole the last wild card spot, or won the division, so they're benching starters. But let's just not assume that. 5-12. It's the worst case of Super Bowl hangover I've ever seen. Anyway, I'm picking the Seahawks to win this one handily. 37-5. I think it's gonna be a total shellacking. No, I'm not. I'm just kidding. That'd be Scorigami though. 37-22. Thirty-nine, actually. Next up. The Saints versus the Bucks. Now, recently, the Saints have owned the Buccaneers, even with Brady. And I don't see that changing, really. While the Saints are going through a lot, and the Bucks are coming off a rough loss, I'd see the Saints doing what they do best. And getting a must win to pretty much keep in track with the playoff race. 'Cause I swear this NFC South division is gonna come down to week 18 with how contested it is. Okay, is it working now? My mic turned off. It's really annoying when that happens. Anyway. Give me those Saints to win an ugly game. No, not 28. 18-16. Uh-oh. I think it's going to be a safety scored. Fuck it. And finally, my tanking Chicago Bears, who have lost the last 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 games. And then before that, lost 3 after starting 2-1. Not terrible losses on paper. Justin Fields is balled out, and we have a really bright future. But it's right now our best interest is to tank. If we win this, oh, we only fall to 4. It's just I really don't know. I really don't know if we can win this one. It's the most winnable Packers game we've had in a while, though. It's way more winnable. Aaron Rodgers isn't playing like himself, but he's still gonna probably dominate us. Justin Fields probably isn't gonna play, but for some reason I feel like we can win this one. And it's gonna be probably the last win. But if not, I won't be terribly mad. But this is probably the last game that I genuinely want us to win, and generally I think we have a chance until probably week 17 and 18, where I think we have a chance if we're in a good position, where we clinched up a top 5 spot by then, that we could probably afford a game or two to win. I have a feeling that come up, but if I'm wrong, I'm not gonna be terribly mad. I'm assuming Trevor Siemian's gonna play, even with Trevor Siemian. I just think this is a trap game for the Packers. If Justin Fields plays, I think we win. Trevor Siemian plays, I think we barely win. If Nathan Peterman plays, it ties. I just feel like this is gonna be an ugly game. Give me the Bears to win their likely last game of the season. If I'm wrong, I don't really care. 25 to 21. Actually, no. 25 to 17. It just feels like a trap game for the Packers. I just feel like we can win it. But I'm probably gonna be wrong. But if we do lose this game, I do think we can win one of these. I think we will win one of these. Probably. I think it's gonna be week 18. We're gonna clinch a top three pick. Or a top two pick. No matter what pick we get, if it's gonna be a top 10, we're gonna trade down. No matter what. And get an extra first round and a second this year, maybe a fourth. So we win no matter what. Bears got a really bright future. I think maybe if we lose this one, we win that one versus the Vikings backups. Or we might win out and make the playoffs at 8-9. Nah, just kidding. We won't do that. That'd be the worst case scenario. Fuck up our draft picks. But yeah. I think we can win that one. It's possible. What happened to the Eagles? Oh, okay. Well, my. Boom, 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 and then boom. Nah, they're gonna beat that. Anyway, thank you for watching. See ya.